I came home one day and I found a telegram under the door. It said there was a audition to work with Charlie Parker at the Tiffany Club at 3 o'clock in the afternoon of that day. So I raced up there and went inside the door. Of course, it was pitch black in there, you know. And you couldn't see anything coming out of the sunlight into a dark room. But when my eyes got used to the darkness, I looked around and I saw 40 trumpet players in there, all the trumpet players in L.A., you know. And I had been there about 5 minutes, and someone must have told Bird or talked to Bird about me before. And after he finished playing with the trumpet player that he was auditioning, he asked if I was in the room, and I said, "Yeah, Bird, I'm here." And he asked me to come up, and we played two tunes together. And at the end of that, he announced over the microphone that the audition was over, and that he was going to hire me, and he thanked everyone for coming, and well, that was it. And when he went back to New York, he told Dizzy and Miles and, oh, I guess Lee Morgan and all those cats, you know, "You cats better look out." He says, "There's a little white cat out in California is going to eat you up." Amsterdam fairly regularly. I have the feeling here that there's much more freedom. People are not so uptight about petty things, you know, as they are in other countries, like the Swiss, you know, or in Germany also. France is a little shaky, and Belgium is terrible too. But Holland is another thing, you know. I mean, a country where you can come into, it's like coming to a country where there's a permanent 24-hour party going on all year.
Such a fool to want you. it's wrong, it must be wrong. But right or wrong, I can't get along without you.
I've been playing 8 years without drums, and really, that's I would call that more cool than anything in the other kind of jazz. Just piano and bass and horn in a trio, or guitar and bass and trumpet, without drums, without any unnecessary ringing of cymbals and noise from the drums. It's just that cool jazz is much more subtle. It has to be listened to very carefully, and you have to know, you have to be able to compare it against something else that you know. I mean, when, and in hot jazz, you know it's going to be louder and more more aggressive. Fantasizes about New Year's Eve parties, you know, with people sitting at tables and funny hats on, and being not so much like a club feeling as where people come in to watch someone perform, but rather getting together at like a big party and the musicians play and have things to eat.
You've had worse New Year's Eves, haven't you?
Yes. Mm-hmm. I really have. Yeah, I was locked up in 62. I mean 60. And I missed that New Year's, and the New Year of 61, they let me out a month ahead of time so I could wouldn't be in jail over Christmas and New Year's. That happened in Italy. But yes, I've had some bad New Year's Eve parties. After 40 years of playing, I mean, my ideas have changed somewhat, basically not, but I found out a lot more about my horn and what I could do with it than I was aware of in 1952. Now it's 1988, and I have all that experience, all those years of having played behind me. So it's normal that I would change during that time, make some progress. I hope it's progress. I'd hate to be going backwards all this time. Continued to bring me a very wonderful gift, and that is that I got through it. I managed to survive. And of course, I've had Diane with me all this year, and that was another gift that a man can really appreciate. And I've had a lot of success all over Europe this year. Every club, every auditorium, or Maison de Culture, Maison de Jeune, has been full. And I just hope that 88 will, if it doesn't have to get any better, if it just stays as good as 87, it'll be fine.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's about that time. I was just telling Diane, I know it's New Year's Eve, but we played 5 days at a very big club, talking about 300-350 people, and you could hear a pin drop in there. I'm playing well enough for that tonight, but just to show you the difference, you know, between, I don't know, you guys have more enthusiasm. Yeah. I don't understand it, but anyway, I want to take this opportunity to wish you all a very happy new year.
And you too!
I hope all your dreams come true. And thank you for coming.
Thank you.